So it was announced a while back that Bleach would be re-airing 13 episodes in collaboration with its best Bleach episodes voted by the people of worldwide, and it will be running on TV Tokyo and Tokyo MX. And I thought, even though I've missed two episodes and this is the 11th one, that I will be doing a video every single week on the Sunday to get used to doing weekly content for the episodes and figuring out how I'm going to be doing things in terms of live reactions go, even though technically this isn't a live reaction because I've already watched the Bleach series. But instead, we're going to be rewatching these episodes and just re-experiencing these things and just have a little commentary and just enjoy the adverts, the content, and just talk about things that we may or may not have missed. And yeah, basically that's it. And also to make up for the lack of videos that I've been doing because I've been extremely ill. So I'm not going to include the sneezes in the reaction itself, so to say. But yeah, at least it's something I can give you on the dot while I actually make some content, or lack of content. So tell me if you like this. Do you want me to carry this on every Sunday? And yeah, I'm also watching these live as well because I also want to see if there's any TV spots, which I imagine that there will be. Generally, probably in the last like 5 episodes mark leading up to October. But before I sneeze, with that being said, let's get right into the reaction, shall we? And if you like this content, hit the like and subscribe as per usual. It really helps me out. But yeah, let's get into it, shall we? And we have the opening. There you go, in HD. Of what we're going to be having in the Blu-ray box sets, so to say. Obviously, I can't play the opening because of copyright, but yeah, I'm just going to keep speaking over it until the auto detect doesn't detect me from YouTube or Aniplex, for that matter. There you go, you got the recap. And it's a shame that they didn't edit the censorship a little bit. I mean, it's to be over expected, but. You know, it would have been a nice thing. I'm not complaining about it. Oh, love it. Everybody loves this feat of Grimmjow. Because this distorted... Is this the one that distorted space? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, look at that. Clean. Clean. And I hope that they do keep the title cards in the new anime. Because that really, like... I don't know, it's the little details. Now, this was really impactful. In the manga, because obviously she's having traumatic experiences with Sora. Again, everything being on model, the details to the scratches on the mask. Again, I love the detail of the faces when it comes to expressing emotion. Ah, the music. Yeah. Sagasu goated, man. Grind. Pantera. Yeah, that's it, like, bro, that's so raw. Literally grinds his sword, or scratches it. And here he is, the Panther himself. Yeah. Nice direction there. I wasn't ever a fan of that shot, because it lacked detail a little bit, but compared to what we're gonna get. Here it is, the jump and hit. Sheesh! Oh! Love to see it, love to see it. Where is he? Where is it? It's coming. Where's Kurosaki? Where is he? Huh, here, look at this shot. Great shot. Sheesh! Boom! Yeah. This is great. And look, man, Apache. She was a banger. I love as well that they actually, you see the sparks, but then like the sound follows afterwards. So it really shows you like the impact of distance of where they're fighting from compared to where Halibel and the crew are at the moment. So yeah, Grimmjow, how is that chest that you like so much? Because it's about to go. I so hope that they keep the spiritual pressure effect. Yeah. I really wish Ichigo did do more like martial arts while using his sword as well. That was always something that I kind of hoped for him. Ah, oh, this is where he grinds. Ah, oh, the way he grinds across the arm. Yeah. Bro, how strong is that Hierro? Oh, I love this. Some good choreography here, man. Not a fan of that cut, I ain't gonna lie, but it looked a bit weird to me. And then we have the adverts. Oh, here's the Blu-ray box set. So here you go. See, so it will be in 4x3. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You feel like number one. gas. Yeah, I'm also watching the live versions as well, because you never know, you might get some TV spots. It's this part, the high-speed soccer go. Here we go. Here we go. Go on, Grimmjow, go on. Love this part. Choreography on point. Oh, this is where he blocks this. Yeah. Ha, you fought. You know, I reckon Orihime could have blocked that, you know. Then again, the mental state, if you haven't watched the Orihime video that I did, yeah, the mental state probably would have broke through the shield, actually. This is like Nell's time to shine in this episode here. Like, I know it's all Ichigo versus Grimmjow right now, but Nell does an amazing part in this. Like, really bringing back, like, Orihime's mentality. Yeah, one of those little bullets, mate. Yeah, not a chance. Again, I think what makes Bleach fights, like, really impactful too. Oh, the crack. Is the effects of, like, the environment as they're fighting. Which really makes the fight feel really full. Yeah, this is equally as important for Orihime as it is for Ichigo right now. The music is just... It really hits. Like, Sagasu, I can't praise the guy enough. He really knows how to hit those notes for, like, these certain situations and moments. Back to back. I mean, even though Ichigo could completely beat Grimmjow at this point, like, he's just enjoying the fight. It's interesting when you think about it like that from a retrospect. This was sick. Nell's talking, if you've read the series Bleach, you know that Nell's talking about, like, how Ichigo's always saving her. So, which is great foreshadowing in a sense as well to what happens later on with Noritora. Nice first person view. POV, you're getting smacked. Yep, and this is where... Again, the detail, the unnecessary detail. It's not unnecessary, but you wouldn't think there'd be that much detail into a character shot. Oh, no, this music. Oh. And you realise that Ichigo's, like, holding back, too, because he doesn't want Orihime to see, like, the monster that she thinks he is. And it's weird to think that Ichigo's enjoying himself at this moment. Get over the PTSD, or he may get over it. Don't die, Kurosaki. Great voice acting there. Oh, and this... Grab that shit. Ugh! It's time to end it. Ugh! Beautiful way to end it. Beautiful. Imagine watching that on a weekly basis, man. Now we get to see if there's any new trailers or key visuals. No. I do believe there is a cons special, though, at the end of the episodes. So I'm just waiting to see what that one is. It's the Women's Association thing, isn't it? I'm trying to remember what the gag is here. Oh, they were supposed to take pictures for like a yearbook or something like that. But all the pictures were behind Kenpachi's head, so L. Well, they all got pictures, technically. Ah, yes. Disney getting into anime. Scary. Very scary. Disney. So yeah, the next episode is, I don't know yet, so I'll probably find out very soon, but if you like this type of content, again, hit that like and subscribe as per usual, and tell me what you think of the commentary. What do you think of the layout? What do you think could be done better? If this is something you like or the video does well on, I'll definitely continue doing them. It's a bit of a test right now, but hopefully it's something that you should at least get something consistently every Sunday if you are waiting for me to upload. So I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been a handsome, and as always, people, peace out.